Have you ever came across a series that gave you a sense of hope, a sense of drive, a series that inspired you to do something? There are many inspiring anime out there that convey messages or themes which could help you and inspire you to be better, and on the rare occasion to pick up a new hobby. Whether it being Gurren Lagann's powerful message of becoming you and believing in yourself, or better said, don't believe in yourself, believe in me, believe in the me who believes in you, or Slam Dunk Shohoku basketball team's constant love for basketball which actually drove many young people in Japan to play the sport, and Haikyuu's overarching message of simple-minded ambition and to always chase your goals no matter how big they are. There are many inspiring anime out there, and today I want to share with all of you the experience with an anime that inspired me to always do my best no matter how things are. This video will also serve as a recommendation, as I'll say what I like about it as well as why you should watch it. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the anime that taught me to always do my best. This is the pet girl of Sakurasou. Well, let me start off this video by telling you guys the exact context of how I was like before watching Sakurasou, what I relate to in the series, how the series inspired me, and what it inspired me to do, how the series changed my mindset, and finally, why exactly you should watch it. I will make reference to a few minor moments in the narrative, and if there is a huge major spoiler, I'll make sure to give you guys a timestamp to skip to. Like I stated earlier, the pet girl of Sakurasou inspired me to do my best at everything I do, doing what I want to do as well as taking the chances and opportunities that came my way without any fear of failure, or better yet, like Misaki said, to leap into space. Before stumbling upon the series, I was very motiveless and quite lazy in fact at the time. Although I still made YouTube videos as well as handling school in the process, I didn't really have a fixed schedule and sometimes fell behind with a lot of things. I also had a very bad habit of procrastinating, and usually I'd eventually end up doing the work at the last minute. At that point in time, I started to not end up doing that said task that I needed to complete. Making videos, something I love, also started to feel like more of a task than it was actually something I enjoyed doing, and for some odd reason, I started to kind of compare myself to other YouTubers and got discouraged at their growth, whilst I still remained lazy, leading to me overthinking tremendously. So, how did a series that seemed to be just another generic rom-com flip my entire horrible sense of drive around and make me always want to do my best? Let me answer that question by first explaining what The Pet Girl of Sakurasou is about. The story follows Sorata, Kanda, a second year high school student who is kicked out of the regular dorms in high school for keeping an abandoned cat in his room. He's forced to move into the high school's infamous Sakura dorm, or how I like to call it, Sakurasou. The dorm is home to the very strangest of students, Misaki, a very energetic upperclassman who happens to be an animator, Jin, a playboy who also loves to write playwright scripts, Ryunosuke, a shut-in like every damn anime fan, who also happens to be a programmer, and Chihiro, the dorm manager, an art teacher, and party girl. How will the very average Sorata deal with and fit in with all of these bizarre students? Straight off the bat, the synopsis may push many people away from trying out the series because of its peculiar nature, but don't leave the video just yet. This anime is strange, but to me, and probably the many other people who have seen it, I found it hitting a bit too close to home. Did I end up moving into a dorm similar to Sakurasou and have friends like Sorata? No, but I went through an almost identical experience as to what Sorata goes through in the first few episodes. I purposely forgot to mention two things in the synopsis. One which, if you were paying enough attention to, you probably would have noticed. The first one is that Sorata has nothing. Misaki has her animations, Jin has his scripts, Ryunosuke has his programming, and the other two members of the Sakurasou dorm also have a goal they work hard towards achieving. Sorata Kanda doesn't have any of that, just like a past version of myself. He doesn't aspire to be anything, and he even quoted that his days felt exactly the same over and over again, with nothing new ever really happening. I especially relate to this because before I started this channel, I had nothing. I didn't want to be anything, and I most certainly didn't have a goal. Every single damn day felt the same, and I sat back wasting my precious time. I didn't have the resolve to jump into space and take the chances that I had. For Sorata, this changed, and it did too for me. Allow me to explain how it happened. Sorata, who basically had nothing, was given a task by Chihiro-sensei. Go meet and pick up the new member of Sakurasou who had just arrived from England. That was when Sorata met Mashiro Shina, an encounter that would change his life forever. Mashiro came to Japan to become a manga artist, and although she looked capable, Sorata soon came to see that she couldn't even look after herself, because all she was focused on was drawing pictures. Sorata had thought that he now had a new purpose. He had to look after Mashiro, helping her with the things she couldn't do for herself. Sorata thought that Mashiro couldn't live without him. After thinking that Mashiro needed him and that she could not live without him for a while, Sorata came to know that Mashiro was actually a world-famous painter, something that crushed him inside. The next day when Mashiro asked him to go with her somewhere, he declined and she proceeded to go with Jin. Misaki, who loves Jin, found out that they were going to a love hotel and decided to bring Sorata along with her to spy on them. Him spying on them made Sorata realize that Mashiro didn't need him and he was just in fact clinging to a false sense of purpose. In other words, he was making an excuse. This was when Sorata had half-heartedly decided that he would leave Sakurasou. This made Sorata feel very human because sometimes I too do things that I don't want to do as a way of lashing out. Another thing which made Sorata more human and made me relate to him more was when he found out that Mashiro had lost her manga competition. But that didn't make him sad, but rather happy. I especially relate to that because I was never really talented at anything and I had to work hard to get the things I wanted. So when I saw someone with pure talent, I was envious, and when they failed, it brought me an evil feeling of comfort, just like it did with Sorata. But back onto how Sorata found his purpose. The next day, when Sorata and his best friend Nanami are searching for owners of his cat so he can move out of Sakurasou, a woman shows up and tells Sorata to come with her. It turns out that Mashiro had lost her manga competition because she ended it very sadly with one of the main characters leaving. Sorata read her manuscript and actually saw that Mashiro had based the manga on the members of Sakurasou's daily lives and their interactions. He then saw that the character who had left was based on him, and after he left, it made everyone sad. Sorata then realized that he wanted to choose for himself what he wanted to do. He wanted his own ending and not a half-hearted one. He ran back to Sakurasou and screamed out loud in front of Mashiro's door about his dream of wanting to create video games, but he found Mashiro to be asleep during his entire speech. It was heard by somebody else though, Misaki and Jin, his upperclassmen, and although he was embarrassed at first, he declared that he wanted to stay at Sakurasou and that he will pursue his dream of creating video games for a living. This moment hit incredibly close to home for me, so allow me to tell you how I found my purpose and started doing the things that I love to do. Ever since 4th grade, I loved playing soccer, or football, but I'll call it soccer for nostalgia's sake. I wasn't really talented or anything, so I had to work extremely hard to become good at the game. And after about 3 years, my interest in the sport began to rapidly decline. I didn't care whether I did well or not, and even though I went for tryouts every single year, the tryouts that year didn't even end up mattering to me, and I only ended up participating because my friends were doing it. After that, the entire pandemic came around, and I completely lost interest in soccer, and ironically, the exact same thing actually happened to Sorata, although he played soccer for 9 years. A little while after I lost interest in the only thing that I had really loved for the past 3 years, I came back to a new hobby interest, which I loved as a kid. Anime. Well, I fell in love with it and found something I adored even more than soccer. Eventually, I wanted to do more than just watch anime. I wanted to make all kinds of content surrounding the medium, but for a long time, I held back on the idea and made many excuses as to why not to start. Why did I do that, you ask? Simply because I was afraid. I was afraid of losing motivation and having all of the time, all of the blood, sweat, and tears I put into making content be all for nothing, just like how it was with soccer. This carried on for about 3 months until I was at one of the lowest points in my life. But then I thought, so what if I lose motivation? So what if I'm scared? I'm going to leap into space and give it a try regardless of my fears. I'll do what I want to do and make it possible, just like Sorata. One of the reasons this show became one of my favorites was because I related to it so damn much. I'm sure that some of you are probably asking the question in your heads of how the series actually inspired me, because up until now I've only spoken about how I relate to Sorata and how I found my purpose in life. Yes, I had found my purpose, but my journey from then on wouldn't be all sunshines and rainbows. I had wanted to quit YouTube before, I had been extremely frustrated, I had been burnt out, and well, It's exactly the same in Sakurasou. Sorata and his friends go through many hardships throughout their journey, whether it being the painful reality that even though Sorata had worked hard, he might never make it and be rewarded. The sad truth that Nanami faced when it was evident that her 2 years of working hard to become a voice actress might have been for nothing, and her not being able to come to terms that hard work might not pay off. Mashiro's troubled path to empathy and coming to know that she hurt those around her by just doing what she loved, Jin having to push away the one he cherished most to chase his dream, and Ryunosuke becoming aware of the fact that by protecting his heart from harm, he damaged those who were trying to reach out for him. I had gone through terrible hardships too, and had the fear that none of my blood, sweat, and tears would be rewarded. But what really inspired me was not the sense of relatability I got from the show, but rather the lessons the show conveyed. All of these characters went through hardships, but they just kept working hard because it was something that they wanted to do, and not only towards achieving their goals, but also towards becoming kinder and helping out those they love. The pet girl of Sakurasou inspired me to work hard, not for any other reason than because I love what I'm doing and that I want to do this. The show taught me not to compare myself with others, because if I did, I'd eventually get swallowed up and be destroyed. And when I came around to understanding that quote and message, I knew why I stopped loving soccer. It was because I always compared myself with those around me. My friends that I played soccer with were very talented, and whilst I played, I always seemed to compare myself with them, and eventually, I think I picked up a habit of just trying to match up to them and not play because I enjoy the actual game, but rather to get praise from them. I was destroyed by pure talent, not because I grew tired of the sport or they were just too good, but because I was playing for a half-hearted reason, and that was not what I wanted to play for. Sakurasou completely blew away the idea of excuses and doing something I don't want to do from my mind. Now I work my hardest towards creating videos on YouTube, posts on Instagram, and also slowly getting back into soccer. And whenever I'm feeling down or lazy, I just think back on Misaki, Sorata, Nanami, and the rest of the Sakurasou cast doing their best no matter what, and that makes me want to do the same. I am very grateful for the pet girl of Sakurasou for the very valuable lessons it taught me and the way it helped me. That's why I believe I should be able to share those lessons with you guys, my precious viewers, and that you should be able to experience them. So, why should you watch The Pet Girl of Sakurasou? Simply because it's amazing. It balances all of its tones well and has very realistic yet likable characters, along with conveying a plethora of valuable themes and lessons. Sakurasou is also the only series with Misaki Kamiigusa, one of the most fun and likable characters I've ever came across. The cast is amazing because they feel like real people and go through very relatable experiences, and the story is great because it hits close to home and handles everything it wants to do well. After watching The Pet Girl of Sakurasou, I now have the courage to leap into space and do whatever the hell I want to do. Recently, I've also begun taking programming courses and trying to be kinder to everyone around me, because I enjoy that, and because I want to do that. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the series that inspired me to always do my best. This is the series that will resonate with me for many more years to come. This is a series everyone needs to watch. This is The Pet Girl of Sakurasou. That brings us just about to the end of the video. If you enjoyed, a like is always appreciated, and if you like this type of content, I highly suggest you consider subscribing, as you'll be able to watch and experience many more videos just like this. Tell me down below in the comments if you are going to watch Sakurasou, and what is an anime that inspired you. This is going to be me signing off. Remember to leap into space and work hard to whatever you want to, because you want to do it. Stay safe, and I'll catch all of you guys in the next one. Peace!